The simple answer to how immutability helps with thread safety is basically the same as with laziness. If data does not change, it means that any number of threads can access it at any moment and they don't mess with each other. But of course, the whole point of running a program is that we want to do something with data, not just read it. Data on which the program operates has to be mutated at some point in time, and so if the program runs on two or more threads, those threads can access the data and get different results. There's just no silver bullet here. Functional programming will not save you from all bugs originating from shared access to mutable data, but it will help a bit. As an example, let's discuss something I see a lot when working on the Android platform. Displaying elements, rows of buttons with titles on them, tiles with pictures, etc., is done through adapters. An adapter keeps a list of items given to it from the outside and based on data from some data source. When the data changes, the list of elements is updated and the adapter is prompted to refresh and display elements created from that new list of items. A simplified version of the adapter's code using mutable collections looks something like this. We have a class, let's say dataset, which keeps a mutable list buffer of items, and then we have a method onClick, which gets an index of the item, and then we do stuff on that item. Then we create a dataset as a val, immutable here, and then we have a method updateList, which from the outside it gets a new list of items, and then we change the items in the dataset to those new items, and we notify dataset changed. That method is used by Android to refresh the screen. And then for every item, we have this case class button holder, which takes the view in which buttons are displayed and takes the dataset. And when the user clicks on the button on the screen, then this onClick method is called, and that in turn calls dataset onClick with the getAdapter position, so that is the position of the button in the list of buttons. Let's assume that the button holder onClick method is called when the user clicks or taps on the screen on one of the displayed buttons. The button holder knows about its position in the adapter, which corresponds to the index of the item which was used to create and display the given element. We don't want to have a lot of logic in button holder, so we just call the onClick method in the dataset, giving it the position of the button. Now, notice that the button holder gets a reference to the dataset in the constructor. And then, within the dataset, we have a mutable list buffer. In the common case, it works very well. The adapter receives a list of new items in the updateList method, the old list is cleared and its contents replaced with the new items, and then notifyDatasetChanged is called, which is a method from the Android SDK that uses the items to create and display buttons. Each button is created from exactly one item, and when it is clicked, we can access the corresponding item and do something. The problem is, notifyDatasetChanged only notifies Android that the dataset changed. Android is then allowed to refresh the screen when it thinks it's a good time to do so, not necessarily right away. So what will happen if in the meantime we register a click? We still have the old button holder on the screen. It will receive the click and then call dataset_onClick with its old position. But the data in the dataset is already different, and that new position may point to a different item from the one we expect, or it may point to nothing at all. We can't let it happen. And the way to do it is to replace a mutable collection in a dataset assigned to a val with an immutable one in a dataset assigned to a var. So now we have again the case class dataset that takes a list of items. Then we have the onClick method, very similar to the one before. And we have a data set, which is a var here. And in the update list, when we take the list of new items, we replace that data set with a new data set, which contains the new items. And then we call notify data set changed. And in the case class button holder, we now have a var of dataset, and we bind it. Binded is also a method that is used by Android. And then we have the onClick method, which calls the dataset onClick method, given that the dataset is already bound to the button holder. Now, when a button holder receives a click and passes it to dataset onClick with its position, we can be sure that we will operate on the same dataset which was used to create the button. The list of items remains unchanged until Android actually decides to refresh everything, and then it will use the bind method to replace the dataset. But at this point, also the position of the button in the adapter will change, or the whole button will be recreated. Note that it doesn't solve all our problems. After all, we are not in the happy top left corner, but in the somehow meh top right corner. It is possible, for example, that two threads will work on the update concurrently, and one of the updates will soon be replaced by another, and we may end up with inconsistency. The other thread will assume the results are as computed in it, and perhaps later try to access an element which doesn't exist. There are a number of things you can try, but it's a fairly advanced topic and it's outside the scope of this series. One final hint, try to always use the original source of data. Don't store a copy of a mutable reference in a cache. When the original one changes, your copy of it will become obsolete. Instead, keep an immutable reference to the entity which encapsulates that data and controls its changes, and access it when you need the data. One way to do it is to introduce dependency injection into your code. You can read more about it at the Software Mills website. They also have their own dependency injection framework called MacWire, which we use at my work, and I'm very happy with it. In a way, this approach indirectly promotes the idea of having a single source of truth. For each dataset in the program, there should be only one place where it is kept, and there should be a unified way to access it and update it. No duplication, no sneaky hacks for corner cases. Memory caches, yes, but only when done in such a way that they are invisible from the outside. If another piece of code wants to retrieve an element from the data source, it shouldn't know or even care if the element comes from the cache or not. Oh, and one more final hint, never use a mutable collection assigned to a var. If you feel forced to use it, it only means there's something horribly wrong with the code. This is all I have prepared for you about thread safety. In the next video, we will talk a bit about expressions and the concept of pure functions. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or want to contact me for another reason, you can just leave a comment below. Or you can also find me on Twitter. See you next time.